Good evening, friends. Welcome to night prayer, coming to you from St. Vincent de Paul Parish here in Shepherd, Michigan. Very thankful always for this time to share with you. I chose to be kind of close to the altar today. God is always able to transform things in our lives to help us grow in faith, grow closer to Him. I have the great privilege of twice every weekend and three times during the week to be right at this altar, whether it's sharing in the sacrifice at Mass or sharing the fruit of the sacrifice in the Eucharist at Word and Communion services. And I hope that none of us ever take for granted the awesome gift of the Eucharist and the ability to celebrate Mass. Let us take a moment now to quiet ourselves from the busyness of the day. Allow us to become aware of Christ's very presence within us. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, come to my assistance. Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. My brothers and sisters, let us take a moment now to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves for this celebration. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Now I ask you to join me in song with Day Is Done.
Bless.
In love safekeeping still we abide. God of love all evil quelling, sin forgiving, fear dispelling, stay with us, our hearts indwelling. Have mercy, Lord, and hear my prayer. When I call, answer me, O God of justice. From anguish you released me. Have mercy and hear me. O men, how long will your hearts be closed? Will you love what is futile and seek what is false? It is the Lord who grants favors to those whom he loves. The Lord hears me whenever I call him. Fear him, do not sin. Ponder on your bed and be still. Make justice your sacrifice and trust in the Lord. What can bring us happiness, many say? Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. You have put into my heart a greater joy than they have from abundance of corn and new wine. I will lie down in peace, and sleep comes at once. For you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Have mercy, Lord, and hear my prayer. In the silent hours of night, bless the Lord. O come, bless the Lord, all you who serve the Lord, who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. Lift up your hands to the holy place, and bless the Lord through the night. May the Lord bless you from Zion, he who made both heaven and earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In the silent hours of night, bless the Lord. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord, your God, with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Take to heart these words which I enjoin on you today. Drill them into your children. Speak of them at home and abroad, whether you are busy or at rest. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed us, Lord, God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake we may keep watch with Christ, and asleep, rest in his peace. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake we may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. Let us pray. Lord, be with us throughout this night. When day comes, may we rise from sleep to rejoice in the resurrection of your Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May the all-powerful Lord grant us a restful night and a peaceful death. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy toward us. And after this exile, show us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I ask you now to join with me in the prayer to the Virgin Mary for protection. Thank you, Eileen, for reminding me to post it. It is now on the parish Facebook page in two locations, both in text format as a note and also as a JPEG image with a nice little border around it. Let us pray. O Mary, you shine continuously on our journey as a sign of salvation and hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick. At the foot of the cross, you participated in Jesus' pain with steadfast faith. You, Our Lady of the Assumption, know what we need. We are certain that you will provide, so that, as you did at Cana of Galilee, joy and feasting might return after this moment of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform ourselves to the Father's will and to do what Jesus tells us. He who took our sufferings upon himself and bore our sorrows to bring us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. We seek refuge under your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our pleas, we who are put to the test, and deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, with great confidence in the love of the Father, let us turn to him with our petitions, these that I will read here and those that you may offer online right now. For those who are suffering in the current outbreak of sickness, that they might be healed, and for the happy repose of all who have died from this sickness in recent weeks, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this difficult and uncertain time, that they will be filled with wisdom and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That in times of illness, our merciful and loving Father will strengthen our faith and trust in his goodness and divine providence. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That our compassionate Father would touch all affected by the current outbreak with healing and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for the prayers we carry in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merits. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you again, all, for joining in as we pray together. Few announcements here. I will be praying with all of you in spirit tomorrow. I plan to watch the Cathedral Mass when that comes on at 10 o'clock. A special thanks to the folks who are making phone calls to parishioners, checking to make sure that they're okay, seeing if there's any needs that are that the parish needs to provide. And a special thanks also, please, to our superb staff that we have here, doing amazing things and coming up with great ideas on how to accomplish the various challenges that we've been dealt with. I'm so very appreciative for them all. And ask a little help. I think Joshua and or Morgan are on right now. So if you could help with this, we have time right now. And I'm imagining that there may be others. Since I've moved here, I haven't baked bread. I've done pizzas, but I haven't baked bread. And we used the last of our bread yesterday on grilled cheese sandwiches for on a Friday in Lent, so needed to make some more bread, and I decided rather than buying some, I would make some, and so I made bread for the first time, and of course, I also wound up making brioche, which is far more complicated than I was imagining, but hopefully it will come out well. So if Morgan or Joshua could start a post on Facebook where people could share something new that they've tried or something that they haven't had an opportunity to do, whether it's cooking a new recipe or a new family game or something like that. Just realizing that in our hardships there are also opportunities. I thank you for the time to gather. I look forward to seeing you here at 9 p.m. tomorrow as we gather again on the Lord's Day for night prayer. May the Lord bless and keep you. May his face shine upon you, and may he be gracious to you and hold you in the palm of his hand. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you now and forever. Amen. Good night, and God bless.